Yes.
So, you've decided that you want to get that sweet, sweet JDM driver's license. You want to rock that toge harder than Fujiwara Takumi. Cruise the streets of Tokyo hella flush, slam to the ground, exude that epic JDM glow, no place other than in its native turf. Well, you may have one hell of a roadblock ahead of you, and just like an AE86 on the uphill, it ain't exactly a pretty picture. If you're blessed to be born in the land of the free, then you may be cursed with another reality, that is having a non-transferable license in Japan. Due to each state having separately issued driver's licenses and a separate set of regulations, Japan does not honor the license for an easy plug-and-play switch. But fear not, my friends, you're not alone. There is a way to win this uphill battle. So stay tuned for this week's Japan Strategy Guide: Tips for a Japanese Driver's License. Tip number one: obtain an international license before coming to Japan. Utilize the limited one-year international driver's license to hone your JDM skills. Frankly, the odds will be stacked up against you, especially if you happen to be American. However, securing an international license beforehand may be an ace up your sleeve. Technically, if you are a resident in the country, they say that you cannot drive without a valid Japanese driver's license. However, it's kind of a gray area if you do have an international license issued by AAA, for example. For the first year, it is valid to use, kind of. The first year will be your chance to either rent a car or practice with a Japanese friend of yours and get used to many of the hurdles regarding Japanese traffic situations. Driving on the opposite side of the road can be tricky, and you need to break some old habits, referring to us American homegrown drivers especially. Some things to keep in mind would be the opposite location of the blinker, usually located on the right side in Japanese cars, the location of your shifter on the left side, and remembering to keep an eye on your center line is a good habit to form. Additionally, the flow of traffic is on the left side generally, and you cannot turn on any red light in any given situation. Of course, this just takes practice, but if you think you can wing it on the test day, you may be in for an unpleasant surprise. Definitely don't waste the first year. It's actually illegal to go back to your home country once you are a resident and renew the international license. This is the case because your visa would have already been issued and you are an official resident of Japan. So it's required to have the official Japanese license by that time if you want to have the right to drive. So practice, practice, practice during that first year. Tip number two: have all your documents in order. Before attempting to dash your way to the nearest driver's license center, be ready to cut your way through more red tape than you may have originally imagined. For this video, I'll be speaking about the Gaimen Kirikae process, that is, transferring your existing valid driver's license from your home country into a brand new Japanese one. Sounds easy enough, right? Well, it can be if you are from certain countries, but if you are from America, like me, things can get a bit tricky. The driving license center will require your valid passport, a valid driver's license from your home country, a legal translation of the license through the Japan Automobile Federation, for example, and your current Japanese residence card. Additionally, you will need a special document, proof of residence, from your ward office. This is called a Juminhyo. You can acquire the license translation by mail if you currently live in Japan, and I will link that information in the description below. One thing to point out that I really want to stress, in order to avoid much heartache and frustration, is make sure that your driver's license from your home country shows that it was issued at least 3 months before you left the country. they want to verify that you have been driving with that license for at least 3 months before coming to Japan. This may be hard to prove, so it might even be a good idea to bring an old expired license if you have it. The more the merrier, and you really don't want to be sent home due to inadequate proof. If you successfully submit all of these documents in person and pay the required fee, you will be eligible to take the written traffic regulation test on the spot. Recently, it is a computerized test, at least in Tokyo, and it should be a breeze since you can do it in your native language. You only need a 70% minimum to pass that test, and I will link a practice test below as well, and you can check that out for your reference. It has some randomized questions, so if you do all of those, you should be good to go. It'll cover general driving rules, the meaning of some of the Japanese traffic signs, and for the most part, it's pretty logical. You'll be then allowed to schedule your behind-the-wheel test on a different day. The whole ordeal took me about 3 hours, and I did go to the driving license center in Tokyo, so expect at least that much time on your first visit. Tip number 3. Know your enemy. The behind-the-wheel test. If you've made it this far and successfully got all of your docs in, passed the written exam with flying colors, then give yourself a nice pat on the back. Now, unfortunately, is where the real battle begins. Unlike in America, the actual driving test will be administered by the Japanese police. This can be quite intimidating, especially on your first attempt. They will be testing your ability to follow all the traffic rules and demonstrate your ability to drive while following their test commands around an isolated driving course. The method of the test is in many ways nerve-wracking, and soon you will realize that it is most likely by design. You will take the test in sequence with your group based on if you signed up for the automatic or manual transmission test. The group for the manual transmission is much smaller, so I'd definitely go for that one. And in Japan, the license is restrictive based on the test that you took. So acquiring the manual transmission license, of course, will allow you to drive both, so that's just the more beneficial one to choose. Now, if you watched Initial D Season 4, which you probably did, you will remember that Ryosuke advised Keisuke and Takumi to walk the course before one of their key Project D Toge battles. Now, every episode of Initial D may have been heavily exaggerated beyond imagination and almost ridiculous. But I'll tell you what, Ryosuke was right about this one. He told them to walk the course beforehand, and you really have to do that too. So try to go to that test course on the weekend. They do open on the weekend. Take your friend with you, maybe you can use your friend's car. Practice on that course, walk the course, do anything you need to do to get familiar with it. Because I'm telling you, from my experience, looking at the diagram that they provide you, or just the diagram at the driving license center, will not be good enough. I recommend a little bit of prep beforehand, anything you can do to improve your odds of passing the test. Of course, you can try it off the bat, and you may pass, but to be honest, you have a very high probability of failing, and you'd have to wait another month to retake it because there's a really, really long queue of people trying to take the exam every month. And so either way, you will become very familiar with the course. You choose which method you want to do. Tip number 4, Japanese. This may go without saying, but aside from the written exam, everything will be in Japanese. This means all the staff at the license center, the police giving you the test, they will only be giving commands in Japanese, explaining any of your successes, failures, or corrective advice. It'll all be in Japanese. So if you aren't a native speaker, make sure you have at least conversation ability. You could, of course, bring your friend or partner to play translator, but remember that on the driving test day, it will only be you, the cop, and the next student in the back of the car. And since the choice to pass or fail you is heavily based on the cop's subjective mood and strictness, it would be in your best interest to make their job easier and with less complication. This is just from experience. When I took the test, there was a couple people in my group that weren't able to speak any Japanese, and they didn't pass, at least on the day that I was there. It might have been the skill problem, but it might have also been the inability to communicate. I could tell that the officer was a bit frustrated trying to give them commands, and they weren't able to respond very effectively. So keep that in mind. Just, you know, do the best you can. If you're still studying, do the best you can. Effort will go a long way. Remember to be polite, give your best smile, and prepare for the test. And that's all you can do. Just stay positive. Good luck. I hope this video will benefit anyone who's trying to get their Japanese license. I put together some of the things that I learned during my experience. I know there is a lot of detail here, so if you have any questions on anything I mentioned, or if I overlooked anything and you want to tell me that in the comments section below, I would really appreciate it. And I will include those links that I mentioned in the description below for the Japanese Automobile Federation for getting that in the mail translation, and for the practice test for the written examination. So check out for those in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. I will be posting more videos related to Japan. Thanks again for watching. Until next time.
Subscribe してください。
すいません。ここから免許センターは近いですか？
そうですね、少し遠いですよ。車であればすぐですけど。